This call for people to wear masks in public has been growing over the past several days.
We're still waiting on official guidance from the CDC on this. It's expected to be a significant change to what we're told at the beginning of the outbreak. Dr. Frank McGeorge here now to explain why this is happening.
I warned everyone from the beginning weeks ago, the advice we give would change over time as the situation changes and as we learn more about this novel virus. The evolving view on masks is based on both a change in our community and some new information. While originally thought to spread primarily through large respiratory droplets when we cough or sneeze, experts now believe there is a significant amount of spread linked to people even without symptoms. That means the virus could be transmitted in a fine aerosol simply by talking or breathing.
The idea of someone who's asymptomatic shedding high titers of virus is very disturbing, because that person could be out there feeling well and inadvertently and innocently spreading the infection.
Another factor in favor of wearing masks, we've now reached a high level of community spread. You need to assume that anyone you come in contact with could be infected. Now, one important goal of face covering is to reduce the risk of you spreading the virus to others. But even if everyone wears a mask, it is not a substitute for more effective measures, including staying home, social distancing, and washing your hands frequently. There is still much to learn about this new virus.
We have to be humble. I've been doing infectious diseases now for almost 50 years, and I could tell you, I don't fully understand exactly what the mechanism that is, and we really need to figure it out, because it could be completely devastating rapidly in one person and absolutely nothing in another person.
Now, you can make a homemade mask out of fabric or even a bandana, but it needs to be secure so you don't need to touch or adjust it while it's on. And this is important. Wash your hands before you put it on and after you take it off. Also, wash the mask regularly. Back to you.
All right. Thank you, Doc. And if you do want to make a fabric mask, you can find some how-to videos on the coronavirus page at clickondetroit.com.